Welcome to Vespers from First United Methodist Church of Ann Arbor. Tonight we conclude our series, O God, Our Creator. But our praise and thanksgiving to God will never cease. The vastness of God's creation cannot be described in mere human words, but some authors draw us closer than we can and our own. So in the words of scripture, song, and prayer, we give praise to Holy God for all that we have been so richly blessed with. Let us worship God. Join me in this responsive call to worship. In the beginning, before time, before people, before the world began,
God was.
Here and now among us, beside us, enlisting the people of earth for the purposes of heaven.
God is.
In the future, when we have turned to dust and all we know has found its fulfillment,
God will be.
Not denying the world, but delighting in it. Not understanding the world, but redeeming it through Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit.
God was, God is, God will be.
Let us sing, This is My Father's World, verses 1 and 3.
This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world, I rest me in the thought of rocks and trees, of skies and seas, His hands the wonders wrought. This is my Father's world. Oh, let me ne'er forget that though the wrong seems oft so strong, God is the ruler yet. This is my Father's world, why should my heart be sad? The Lord is King, let the heavens ring, God reigns, let the earth be glad.
Join me tonight in tonight's psalm, Psalm 96, from the Common English Bible. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Share the news of his saving work every single day. Declare God's glory among the nations. Declare his wondrous works among all people, because the Lord is great and so worthy of praise. He is awesome beyond all other gods, because all the other gods of the nations are just idols. But it is the Lord who created heaven. Greatness and grandeur are in front of him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Give to the Lord, all families of the nations, give to the Lord glory and power. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring gifts. Enter the courtyards. Bow down to the Lord in his holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth. Tell the nation, the Lord rules. Yes, he set the world firmly in place. It won't be shaken. He will judge all people fairly. Let heaven celebrate, let the earth rejoice, let the sea and everything in it roar, Let the countryside and everything in it celebrate. Then all the trees in the forest, too, will shout out joyfully before the Lord, because he is coming. He is coming to establish justice on the earth. He will establish justice in the world rightly. He will establish justice among all people fairly.
The second verse of How Great Thou Art.
When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Our scripture this evening comes from the book of Genesis, chapter 2. Verses 4 through 22. Another account of God's work in the creation. This comes from the Common English Bible translation. On the day the Lord God made earth and sky, before any wild plants appeared on the earth, before any field crops grew, because the Lord God hadn't yet sent rain on the earth, and there was still no human being to farm the fertile land, though a stream rose from the earth and watered all of the fertile land, the Lord God formed the human from the topsoil of the fertile land and blew life's breath into his nostrils. The human came to life. The Lord God planted a garden in Eden in the east, and put there the human he had formed. In the fertile land, the Lord God grew every beautiful tree with edible fruit, and also he grew the tree of life in the middle of the garden, and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. A river flows from Eden to water the garden, and from there it divides into four headwaters. The name of the first river is the Pishon. It flows around the entire land of Havilah, where there is gold. That land's gold is pure, and the land also has sweet-smelling resins and gemstones. The name of the second river is the Gihon. It flows around the entire land of Cush. The name of the third river is the Tigris, flowing east of Assyria, and the name of the fourth river is the Euphrates. The Lord God took the human and settled him in the Garden of Eden to farm it and to take care of it. The Lord God commanded the human, "Eat your fill from all of the garden's trees, but don't eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, because on the day you eat from it, you will die." Then the Lord God said, "It's not good that the human is alone. I will make him a helper that is perfect for him." So the Lord God formed from the fertile land all the wild animals and all the birds in the sky and brought them to the human to see what he would name them. The human gave each living being its name. The human named all the livestock, all the birds in the sky, all the wild animals. but a helper perfect for him was nowhere to be found. So the Lord God put the human into a deep and heavy sleep, took one of his ribs, and closed the flesh over it. With the rib taken from the human, the Lord God fashioned a woman and brought her to the human being.
Genesis 2 is another retelling of the creation story. A different voice, a different style. How does this perspective influence your understanding of God and God's creation?
Let us pray. God, our Father, you created the world and sent your own Son to live among us, made of the same stuff, breathing the same air, marveling at sunrise and sunset just as we do. Help us to participate in life around and within us as your life. As you living in us, and we living in you and in each other. God of love and life, restore us to your peace, renew us through your power, and teach us to love all that you have created, and to care for the earth as your gift and our home. Amen.
We come to a close now for this evening and our Vesper services until the fall. Our schedule will undergo some transformation with a return to preparing ourselves during the seasons of Advent and Lent. Check the latest news or Know, Love, Affirm newsletter for up-to-date information as Advent draws nearer. Till then, we pray that you continue to find a place of quiet, calm, and prayer during your week. May your rest bring you peace, and moments of silence always bring you an awareness of God's presence within you. For truly God is within us and among us, if we but open our eyes and ears and hearts. God be with you till we meet again.
Our benediction song, Go Now in Peace.
Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere. you may go. Go now in peace, go now in peace. May the love of God surround you everywhere, everywhere.